Hello all, welcome back students. So in this video we will complete up and discuss the last question of previous week's assignment that was given. And I think that question talks something about mobile numbers, and if you had closely monitored the video module, in one of the video module I talked about I think two functions, and I told that these functions can be used to check whether any given element or any given roll number or any given mobile number is actually present or not. Okay, I think I discussed two functions if I am not wrong. One of the function is index and one function is count. Okay, for details you can go through the video module, which will explain in depth and very properly how this index and count functions are actually working. Okay, we will see what we can use is in this, but let us first of all read the program, and let us divide the program into multiple parts so that our logic buildup can work up perfectly. The first thing that is discussed here is write a program to take input of any 5 mobile numbers and add them to the list mobile. This is not the only case. Program should allow only 10 digit mobile number to be entered. Okay. Now I think in the previous chapter strings in Python, I think I already had discussed a program where a user or program should accept only a valid email. Okay, in the same way in this program, my program is designed in such a way that program should accept only what you can say valid or 10 digit mobile number. Okay, so I think we can have proper check for the same. Nevertheless, let us read the first line of the program. First line of the program says that we have to take input of 5 mobile numbers and add to the list mobile. So at least let us make some of the things ready. Name of the list is mobile. So I have created a blank list. How many mobile numbers do I want? I want only 5 mobile numbers. So it is understandable that we should not ask the user that how many elements does he want in the list. It is very specifically mentioned in the program only that there should be 5 mobile numbers. So I need not specially ask the user how many numbers are required. How many mobile numbers are required? 5. So I think I can run the loop for 0 to 5. So technically it will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and loop will execute 5 times. Okay. So write a program to take input of 5 mobile numbers. My loop is going to be executed 5 times and add them to the list mobile. No problem. First we will design a simple program that mob equal to input. I will write a message that enter 10 digit mobile number. Enter 10 digit mobile number, and we will see the condition later on. If condition is true, what we have to do? We have to add that mobile number into my list. So what is the syntax? List name dot append and element. My element is mob. So this is done, and after that I will print list of mobile numbers, and list of mobile numbers is simply I will print the name of the list mobile. Okay, so I think this will work perfectly if I am going to enter any mobile number properly. But there is one tiny condition given in the program that we will read. Program should allow only 10 digit mobile numbers to be inserted. Okay, program should allow only 10 digit mobile number to be inserted. That means if user is entering 5 mobile number, and suppose if one of the mobile number is not of 10 digit, so that mobile number should not be added. So that mobile number should not be added into the list. Okay. So first of all, I want to have a discussion with you that how shall I check whether mobile number is 10 digit or not? No problem. First thing. See, this is not that of an easy program as you might be thinking. So first thing you might be saying, sir, that sir, let us take length. Length of what? Let us take length of mobile number. Okay, no problem. If length of mobile equal to 10. Okay, so if length of the mobile number which the user is entering is 10, then only our program should add the mobile number into the list. I hope you are understanding. If length of the mobile number is 10, then only program should add the mobile number into the list. Else we can print a message that please enter mobile number properly. Okay, now properly can include XYZ things, but to be very specific, please enter mobile number of 10 digits only. Okay, we can print a message like that, of 10 digits only. Okay, let us run the program. But even before running the program, I am extremely sure that my program will not work, and that is what I wanted to show you. No problem. Let us run the program. Let us enter mobile number. Let us enter any random mobile number. Definitely program will not work. The only reason this long has no length. Long is another name for integer. Integer has no length. Okay. So we learnt in the previous chapter, that is strings in Python, that we can make use of length function only with string. Okay, I would like to do a small sub program for the same. Let us take that m equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and n equal to, I am using a string a, b, c, d, e. Now what if I do print length of n? You will see that it will work. But if I start doing print length of m, it will stop working. Let us save this program. You will see length of n is working and length of the number is not working. That means length of m is not working. Only reason, integer has no length. Means to be very specific and to be very proper, we can make use of the length function only with string or list. We cannot make use of the length function when we have numbers. We cannot make use of the length function when we have numbers. Okay. Now, to make sure that I am able to take the length of this, we have many options, but I will show you the easiest option possible. Now, this is called, what option I am going to exercise is called typecasting. We have done this in 10th standard, but we officially do not know the definition. Typecasting means converting one type to another. Now you will say that, sir, what is type? Types can be integer, types can be float, types can be string, etc. Remember in 10th standard what we were doing? We were doing print 10,3. I told you that students, this will not give you exact answer. So we were doing something like this, and this is what is called as type casting. We are converting integer to float. I hope you are getting what is the meaning of type casting. Type casting in Python means converting one form into another. And what forms we are talking about? Those forms can be integer, those forms can be float, those forms can be string. And already this type of example we have done. Okay, now coming to the current sub program, I wanted the length of m, but program is telling that m is an integer, we cannot take the length, so we have to typecast integer. We have to convert this integer to string. How we will do? String's typecasting code is str, str of m. Now what will happen? M is originally an integer only. What will happen? M is originally an integer only, but when I am running this length of m, as you saw, there is an error. Error is that m is an integer, we cannot take out the length. Python is saying like that. So what we are doing, we are temporarily typecasting m, that is an integer, into a string, and I am very sure it will give us the length of the string. Correct? So the same logic, students, we will be using in our program. As we saw that now our program, if I am entering any number, our program is giving an error that integer has no length. So what we will do, I will type cast this mobile MOB, which is there, which is an integer, into string, so that at least I can get the length of the same. Correct? Now let us see. I am entering first of all a proper mobile number. As you can see, it did not give me any error because it is very simple that mobile is of 10 digits. Now let us enter another mobile number. It will obviously give me an error that please enter mobile number only of 10 digits. Okay. Let us enter another mobile number. Perfect. Again, mobile number is 9 digits only, not accepted. This is supposed to have 10 digits, so it is working. And we can see that all the mobile numbers are entered properly, those who had 10 digits. I know you can see something extra, I can explain that also, give me a moment. But all the mobile numbers which are having 10 digits, only those mobile numbers are entered successfully. Those mobile numbers which were not having 10 digits, we are showing a message that this mobile number does not have digits. I think I will, you can say, change the message. It should have 10 digits only. Fine. Now you will think, sir, what is this L? What is this L? L stands for, you can say, an extended type of integer that is called long. Long is one form of integer, and long suggests that the integer is very large in size. Okay. You should not be worried about the fact that how this will work, sir, or how we will do this, sir. Do not worry. This is only a message that is given by Python for its own use. Remember, long is one type of integer which will suggest only when we are using bigger numbers. And it is coming sometimes. As you can see here, long is not coming, even though this is a 10 digit number, because Python is not recognizing the digits like one place. It is recognizing the digits as per number system. Suppose it is 98 crore, something like this. This is 12 crore, something like this, for example. So do not be worried about this long and other thing. Fine. So students, I think my first part of program is done, because program is lengthy. I will just amend this message. Please enter mobile number of 10 digits only. Okay. And if you want, I do not mind, you can enter this also, that if str of mobile dot is digit. Okay, obviously it will be digit only, but if you want, you can check for the same. Let us have one more proper check whether till now my code is proper. Done. Not done. Not done. Not done. Done. And it is accepting only those numbers out of the 5 numbers which is actually having 10 digits. So till now my program is working very smoothly and it is working very well. Again, let us exercise if characters are allowed. Obviously, as soon as I entered a character by mistake or intentionally, obviously Python is not accepting. Let us see. Let us take a proper mobile number. 9898558819. Instead of 9, I am entering 1p. So obviously length is 10. Length of the mobile number is 10, but there is one character. So obviously it is giving an error. That is what I told you, that we are not totally handling the things. That is okay from our part if we are not doing so. Let us run once again. Let us run once again, because that was not a compulsory part of the program. So here, as you can see, I entered L. So it is not accepting that mobile number. That means from our side, I have handled the program in the best possible manner as per 11th standard logic. Okay, and as you can see, my program is now working precisely. This was an error because of the hash, precisely for mobile numbers, and it is accepting only those mobile numbers which is having 10 digits, and it is not allowing any mobile number which is having characters. Okay, so part one of the program is done. Part two of the program, check whether this mobile number is present in the list or not. Okay, so we will, first of all, this is, you can say, not that a simple program as you might be assuming. Point number one, for checking whether this mobile number, please listen to me carefully, for checking whether this mobile number is there in the list or not, I should be able to access each and element, each and every element of the list. Please listen to me carefully. For first of all checking whether this mobile number is there in the list or not, I should be able to access each and every element of the list. And how we will do it? It is same as accessing each and every character of the string as we used to do in the previous chapter. Please understand and mind my words. For even checking whether this mobile number is there in the list or not, I should be able to access each and every element of the list. Now you might be wondering that, sir, how we will check whether each and element or every element of the list? It is very simple. The same way as we used to check each and every element of the string. If you remember from the previous chapter, we used to access each and every element of or character of the string in straight direction, in reverse direction. The same thing we will do here, same logic. I will just verify. For I in range 0, comma length of string, length of, you can say list. What is my list name? My list name is mobile. Okay. And to be very simple, I will not write any logic. I will just write a code which will print each and every element of the list. Print, what is the list name? Mobile of I. And I am very sure this will print each and every element of the list. Now we will enter proper mobile numbers because I want to access each and every element of the list. Okay. Mobile number done. Mobile number not done. Mobile number done. Mobile number done. Mobile number is working properly. Now, as you can see, number one, my list has four mobile numbers. Done. And I told you, na, this L and everything, I again repeat, it is extended form of integer that is long. Okay. So my mobile numbers are entered properly. And now you can see I am able to access each and every mobile number from the list. So in short, I am able to access each and every element from the list. Correct? Now almost my job is done. I will read. Check whether 799038 2073 is present in the list or not. Okay, so what I will do? Very simple. If 799038 2073 in list, remember, what will this mobile of I give? Mobile of I will give us each and every element from the list as we have exercised. So if this number is in the elements, I will just print a message that yes, 799038 2073 is present in the list. Okay. And what I can do in else, I will just print an opposite message. Let us copy this code that, sorry, this number is not present in the list. And I hope this will be sufficient for my program to work smoothly and properly. Let us run. Let us run. I will now execute the program properly. 9898558819. Done. 9898558819L. Let us not enter L. Let us enter 0. Not done. 789. Not done. 799038 2073, done. Let us say 9537456739, done. Okay, now there is an error. I was assuming that this error may come. Okay then, students, so we have done the coding for the same, and I am very hopeful that my program will work, but still I know that there will be some small issue in the program. Let us exercise it in front of you. 9537456739, working perfectly. Let us take the number which I want to search, 799038 2073, and let us take one more number, 9537456739. Let us take one more number, and let us take a wrong number, so my loop is not executing. Now as you can see, my program is working perfectly. my program is working perfectly here. Okay. Now you might be wondering that, sir, why this message is coming again and again? The simple reason is I have done the hard coding like that. That first this is the number. My code is checking whether each number, if you see the cursor, my code is checking whether each number is same as 7990 or not. If that is the case, yes or sorry is printed. So every time I am checking for the first number, if it is checked, it is not matching, so this is printed. For the second number, it is checked, it is matching, so yes, this is printed. For third number, it is checked, it is not matching, so sorry is printed. For the fourth number, it is checked, it is not matching, so sorry is printed. So my program logically is correct, but there is some minor, you can say, disruption in the program. What is the disruption? I am getting too many messages. I should get only a single message that yes, it is present, or sorry, it is not present. I should get it once only. Otherwise, logically, my program is perfect. But the only thing that I am getting too many messages. So it will confuse the user. Ke bhai, final batao, number hai ke nahi hai? Because kabhi aapka program, once your program is telling sorry, next time your program is telling yes, again your program is telling sorry. So logically, we have handled everything. Just small things we have to do here and there. Okay. Logically, we have handled everything perfectly, students. Okay. So let us see what we can do. Let us see. I think I need to make use of some third party counter, then only this will work. Let us take a variable. This is called program cheating. Okay, let us take c equal to 0. Correct. Let us take c equal to 0. Correct. Let us say that if number is found, I will print c equal to 1. Let us say that if number is not found, I will still print c equal to 0. And once c is 1, I do not see. My main intention is checking whether that number is there in the program or not. So when will c will be 1? C will be 1 only when the number is found. So kya mujhe uske baad aur loop execute karne ki zarurat hai? No. Remember, what is the main intention of my program? That I want to check whether this number is there or not. So once I found this number and once c is 1, do I need my program to execute further? No. So go back to fifth standard looping construct. If I want to terminate the loop, I will write this statement break. Means once this number is found, I do not want my loop to work ahead. Once this number is found, I do not want my loop to do any other calculation. So I will break from the loop. That means my loop will terminate. Now outside, I will print a message that if c is 1, c is 1 means number is present. So I will print that yes, 7990382073 is present. Okay. Now if c is not 1, that means I will print yeah, else. In else, I will just have a normal message that sorry, 7990 to whatever is the number is not present. And I am hopeful now that my program will work. Only minor changes here and there I made. Nothing else. Let us see. Let us see the final program. Mobile number 9898558819. Okay. 7990382073. Okay. 9537456739. Okay. 56. Not okay. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 5. Okay. And as you can see, now my program is printing only the message once that this number is present, not others. Okay. So students, to be very particular, if I had asked this program in theory paper, at least it would be of 4 or 5 marks, not less than that. And you will agree to this. Okay, that yes, sir, there are so many minute things that we are handling. We learned two new things today, or we revised two new things today that I will just write up. One is typecasting. Typecasting is converting one form into another. And we did typecasting at many places. We did typecasting here because membership operator does not work with string. We can use equal to also, that is fine. We did typecasting here because we are not able to directly get the length of integer, so I convert it into string. We did typecasting here, that is one thing. And second is how to come out of a loop in between. once I found this number, I did not want the loop to continue. Okay, so I otherwise if the loop will continue, it will again go 0, then again these messages will be printed again and again. Fine, so I do not want my loop to continue. So once I found the number, once C is coming 1, I am using break statement. Break statement will allow us to break out from a loop, will allow the loop, this loop to terminate in between. And then if C is 1, then this is present. And if C is, you can say 0, then this will be printed. That number is not present. So thank you students for your patience. It is a very big program and this program has some cost also. It is actually a 4 or 5 marks if it is asked in the theory exam. Okay then, thank you students for your cooperation. We will, you can say, cover up more programs in the coming week's assignment.